a bigger fish.
Did I ever tell you how cute you are?
No.
Oh. Wow. They really played off this romance, like every episode.
It's just a terrible romance, though.
That was really good. I love the romance.
Well, hello, Bigger Fish Nation.
Hello.
Hey, it's just us again. We couldn't get a commentator. They all fell through because
they're fat.
Yeah. No, they're not fat.
Yeah, they are.
They're just a little chubby. But we just watched episode 7.
And the curse of the Jindas.
They're back.
That was the weirdest episode yet, probably.
Man, I don't know. Every episode, I'm going to say that.
That was the weirdest episode yet,
and then the next episode
was
This one
I really think is the weirdest one, though.
This one was very incohesive.
It was.
Nothing matched in it. But we'll get to it. So they start off, the episode starts off with them trying to do some trading with, well, they're on a quest to do some trading with some marsupials, but they run into these little Jindas from the last episode who are on their way to a lake to have some free time and bathe. But wait, the curse of the Jindas is happening, and these rocks come down to play tag, or crush them to death. Maybe. I don't know. One of those
Nobody
two.
Knows what the frick the rocks were doing.
But boy, are they cursed
by
these big boulders.
Boy.
So then it cuts back to the Ewoks, and they're like, hey, look, there's this cute rock that we have, and Wicket had these little beans, and they're seeds, they're like little blueberry seeds, and he's like, I can trade them for anything in the store. So you know what he gets? He gets his girlfriend a little present.
A lucky rock.
A lucky rock. Let me just say, the lucky rock comes in handy for some lucky stuff at the end.
So then, the Jindas... What? I don't even... Oh, then they get captured by the raccoon thing.
The raccoon wolves that fly with sort with of the Yosemite Sam little headpiece.
With also the marshmallow stick.
With the marshmallow sticks. That is a good description of
what I didn't think about it. So much happened in this episode that just feels so long.
Yeah,
because
they're a cool design, like everything in this show is.
We didn't even talk about the weird anteater shopkeeper thing, which was cool.
Oh, yeah, the marsupials.
Good to see you, too. What do you want?
They kind of look like anteaters, but kind of grew.
Look, they're going to see
fat.
Them. They're going to see. You don't have to describe them.
I'm going to just use my words.
Okay.
Words are powerful, Aaron.
Images can tell a thousand words, Luke. What do you think of that? Okay. They get captured, and then the Jindas coincidentally come.
Because I guess they never came to this place before, because remember last episode, they can never find where they've been before. But, so they're like, can we do...
There must be a lot of random civilizations in the Ewok forest.
Yeah, we keep
like,
learning about more. We'll get into more civilizations.
I'm actually enjoying these episodes that don't follow like the Duwok / evil crocodile lady.
Well, I haven't said if I like this episode yet.
Okay,
it's definitely weird, but we'll get to that. But so they're perform for them, and then they come up. Well, they come up with a scheme to hide the Ewoks in this Chinese dragon thing. But
well,
I guess
the wizard came up with it, or whatever the frick that thing is.
Yeah.
Not the King Jindas.
He's one of the performers, but he doesn't have a face. He's missing
the shadow. A really cool design.
Oh, yeah. But, so, and then, of course, everything goes wrong, because the big brothers are...
What does Wicket think he's doing?
I don't know, but if Willy steps on my foot again, I'll...
You'd better look behind you, Eva.
Kvark.
And then... Boom!
They escape. I forget how they escaped.
Remember,
tails.
They go and they run away.
On the
Jinda's big lugga beast.
Okay, whatever.
And then so they get back to the Ewok town. They're like, "Oh, thank you, Jindas. You saved our little kids' lives. And then they're like, is there any way we can help them? Then the Jindas have a little melody to tell their whole backstory.
Which is probably my favorite part of the episode.
Oh, yes.
That is so great.
I think I'm just going to put that whole clip in. Cause
yeah, I think you should. Cause it's
a and title. Watch the clip.
Hit it, boys! A one, a two, a three. You see, not long ago, in a far-off land, the Jindas used to farm and lend a hand. We never used to travel far from home. We just grow vegetables and work our bones. Above us lived this wizard of rock. All we did was feed him. He protected our lot. It was a good relationship. This rock wizard loved Jinda cuisine. 'Twas the best he ever tasted, the best he'd ever seen. One day he came storming off his rock, said we tried to poison him with our stock. A foolish idea, we did no such thing, but he sent us from our homeland just the same. He cast a spell to keep us on the move. If we ever returned or fell into a groove, the rocks would rise up like they did today and chase us all around till we made our way. So that's our tale of regret and despair, and that's the reason why we can't stay here. But we've adapted, we've become the best entertainers from here to west of the west.
Welcome back, guys. After seeing that in your line backstory,
after the brief interruption,
now we know all the sad history of the Jindas and how they were just peaceful farmers before they had to become entertainers. I don't know how you become a farmer and he's like, I'm going to become an entertainer.
Look, they had to do something.
Well, let's talk about their instruments, though. Remember? It was like a little butter masher.
Oh, it's my favorite thing. Maybe this is a deep connection because they used to be farmers and they probably need butter.
So everything they play their instruments with, it used to be a farm tool that they made into instruments.
It's so sad.
But remember, that almost comes into play because the Lugabeast used to not, they used to just make little little rows to put their seeds in, but now they're performing big beasts.
Oh.
You're right. But Logray's like, I think I have a plan how to save the day. He's like, Tebow, come here. We're going to do more force-using stuff.
Your power is strong with the forest creatures.
I was going to say. I really thought he was going to say the force.
I didn't think so.
Forest.
Forest, yeah. Almost the forest. But, so, they connect to the animals, and the animals clamp down on all the rocks, and they're like, yay, we saved the day, the curse is lifted, but then everything just, I don't know what happens next. It's bad.
I forget. Oh, then the giant rock guy comes.
How do you forget, Aaron?
I don't know. Giant wizard rock guy comes.
Who dares to fool with my...
He was a cool design. He did cool stuff. He looked like a boss battle.
It was a boss battle. I think he killed a few Ewoks.
Probably.
He'd at least destroyed a home. I don't think they didn't show any on-screen deaths.
Yeah.
But, so he comes, you know, he's like, the Jindas cause me so much pain.
I'm a villain.
But then, remember, that Lucky Stone is going to come back into play. And then he's like, hey, that's my tooth.
It's not the same color as his other teeth.
Oh, yeah, but somehow it fit. He's like,
no, it didn't look like it would have fit from looking at the size of it.
Yeah, and also now he has a necklace thing and gagging his head like, my
tooth. That would have been a great way to end it. Instead of him being happy about getting his tooth, he just chokes on the necklace.
He's like, we can go back to it. Oh, yeah, I forgot to talk about, didn't they try to poison him?
Oh, yeah, they tried to poison the rock wizard guy. They
never said that's, like, a motivation to hit the Jindas. It was just that he lost his tooth. They freaking tried to poison him. I mean,
like did it even say why they tried to poison him? It sounded like they were getting along well.
Yeah. I think they just, like, drunk one night and, like, I said we just poison our kid.
They tried to poison them with, like, terrible crops or something.
With jello, yeah, I don't know. But that didn't work out, so... But...
Yeah.
It's a sad life for the Jindas.
So, like, I guess the whole time he thought it was the Jindas he was mad at, but... He was really just mad that he didn't have a tooth.
I don't know what the moral is in that.
Wait,
that's something we were thinking about. What is the moral of the story?
There's, like, not one.
Don't... Trust in even their stupid people.
Trust in, like...
Trust in
everyone. And God, because God made sure they got the necklace to save them.
You mean the forest spirits?
Yeah. But no, but for us, the moral to us would be to trust in God.
I'll trust in the forest spirits.
So, the moral is that Jesus loves us.
Okay. You have it here, folks.
There you
broken
go.
Down. So, Aaron, do you like this, and would you recommend?
Yeah, I like this episode. It was really incohesive and a bunch of...
I'll
hard
say
to follow, but I liked it.
First 12 minutes, pretty bad. Last 12 minutes, pretty good. They had a good musical numbers.
I like the first 12 minutes.
It had its moments. I like the marsupials. They were interesting.
These has just felt like two separate episodes almost.
Yeah. I never, like, they forgot about the Curse of the Jindas for a good solid 14 minutes. They're like, oh, and then it comes back, the variant. So, not the best, not the worst, just, you know, a middle of the line episode.
Lovely, Chief Chirp Chirp, you did it!
Don't forget, we had a little help from my daughter.
And the stupid little rock?
Well, thanks for watching.
Bye.
Bye.
100th subscriber gets a free t-shirt.
Yeah. It'll say Ewok on it or something.
Or some.
Or maybe Duloc, because if you're a rebel and like bad guys.
Wow, Luke, that's cool.
So join us next time.
The things that Ewoks aren't cool and there's nothing to respect about them. To
yep.
Be honest.
That's why I want a t-shirt about them. But yeah, come back next time for episode 8.
I think they're worse than Gungans.
Yeah, they are.
Ewoks. It pains me to know that this show isn't canon.
Raise the stairs!
They can fly, moron.
Thank you for helping
they can
me.
They can all go far off the ground.